Hello everyone, this is Don Vippo and today I want to talk about my experience with the Granblue Fantasy Versus Rising Beta. Coming into the beta, I have played the original Granblue Fantasy Versus for about 70 hours when it launched back in 2021, but forgot almost all of it. And of course, I am quite the Blaze Blue gamer, if I may say so myself. I played Rising for about 8 hours according to Steam and got 51 matches in with Anila. In this video, I will introduce the game to you, talk about my first impressions and showcase my first and last match of the beta so you see how much I improved over the course of it. You are free to watch it in its entirety or skip to the part that interests you. Either way, enjoy your stay. First, I do have to apologize for showing the game on medium graphics settings here, as my gaming rig is 6 years old by now and not all that strong. Nevertheless, it's still a beautiful game and a sight to behold. Just in case you have not heard of Granblue Fantasy Versus yet, Granblue Fantasy Versus is a ground-based fighting game similar to the likes of Street Fighter, with the main difference being that everyone is access to Merc's anime style hot. It is based on the popular mobile game Granblue Fantasy, which has already spawned an anime and soon will also get its first RPG with Granblue Fantasy Relink. As far as fighting games go, it does a great job of making itself a great choice for newcomers, both in terms of system mechanics and game content, as the game features a button-mashy story campaign with epic boss fights alongside all of the usual stuff, including more in-depth matchup tutorial challenges, where the game gives pointers how to be two options of each character when facing them. As far as we know, they are not going to take anything of that away with Rising. They also added Grand Bruce Legends, a new Fall Guys-like mode in Rising, and offer a free-to-play version with a limited roster when the game launches on December 14th. So, if for whatever reason you have never played a fighting game before, but stumbled upon my channel, Rising is the best starting point for you. I wanted to start my beta experience with a round of Granblue Legends, but I unfortunately could not find one. As far as I am aware, there was no way to queue up for Granblue while playing other modes, so I left it at that and went through the game's tutorial to learn about the new mechanics and get a bit more familiar with the game again. Speaking of mechanics, Granblue still has a 5 button layout with light, medium, heavy and unique attack and a dedicated guard button, 2 dodges, 3 hit auto combos, 2 supers and 4 different specials per character. Specials can be done using a single button or with traditional inputs. Traditional inputs have a slight damage bonus, but all the other downside single button specials had were removed. New in Rising are dash attacks, where the light version is very plus and block, the medium version a low, and the heavy version, well, I couldn't figure out its purpose. They also added enhanced skills with especially strong properties. They take up 50% meter when rifter block, but only 25% when they hit. On top of that, there are 2 new enders for the auto combos, giving every character a low and an overhead. On the defensive side of things, there is Brave Counter, which can be used after blocking an attack or getting hit by the unblockable Raging Strike. It acts the same way as your usual alpha counter, as it sends your opponent away, but can be baited and punished. The biggest change in my opinion is the aforementioned Raging Strike though. It takes 1 diamond shaped bravery point, you know, that thing next to your health bar, and can be used to open your opponent up and even leads to a full combo in the corner. A follow up called Raging Shame, which costs 25% meter, can be used to get a combo anywhere on the screen, but since your opponent can mash your brave counter out of it, I mostly use it for combo extensions. This might sound hyper complicated, especially if you are a beginner. But if you just take it slowly and implement each tool into your toolkit one by one, you will soon get the hang of it. If you ever need a refresher, look up some resources online or redo the tutorials. I did like that you could modify the amount of try runs you have for each lesson though. Although you apparently need to finish each one in order to get the check mark, so going low is an unfortunate pro strat. I found myself not reading the instructions beforehand a lot and then getting a little bit lost, but content-wise the tutorial is just fine. The training mode appears decent, but not perfect. It is missing frame data, but other than that it should have all the features you'd expect. On a similar note, I also like the short videos for each move in the comment list. I know this was also the case in Strife and maybe even in base Granblue, but it's always nice to have a visual guide. For learning combos there will be a challenge mode in the full game, but it was not available in the beta, so I grinded some Anila combos with a video I found online. It took me quite a while to get through 2.5 minutes of combo content, but at the very least I got more familiar with my character. Speaking of characters, the full game will have a roster of 28 characters at launch, while the beta had 26 of them, including newcomers Anila and Siegfried. I only tried Anila, and she plays like a mixture of Terry Bogard and Mei. She has good pokes, projectiles, aka sheeps traveling the ground, a Totsugeki-like move that can be cancelled into a projectile-style move, and a common hop. So all in all, she seems like a solid choice, especially for beginners, as her tools are straightforward and flexible. Once I finished my combo training arc, I connected to the network mode and was promptly asked to rate my experience with fighting games. I chose the middle option as to not ruin the experience for beginner, but seeing how I got destroyed all the time in the beta, I might have been the beginner. Still unsure how to best map my buttons and struggling with my character, I queued up for casual matches. Let's take a look at how that went. So here we are witnessing my first match in Granblue Fantasy Versus Rising ever. My opponent has a lot more matches than I have. He had 160, and of course this is the first match that I have here. But I do have some experience with Granblue Fantasy as a franchise. I played, as I said, about 70 hours with Zeta in Granblue Fantasy Versus, the original, but lots of that was story mode, to be honest, just grinding the cool bosses. So I never was that great of a Granblue player to begin with, and Zeta didn't fit me well. So I'm hoping that Anila is a good pick for me, because she appeared to be kinda similar to Mei with the sheep charge. I don't know if this is that much the case here, but still an interesting pick for me, and I also like her visually and I like the sheep, so that's why I decided to go Anila here. But of course you see here, while in neutral we are both kinda inexperienced, I would say, kinda clumsy. He definitely has the upper hand when it comes to combo, even though his combos are not great. He at the very least knows how to operate the character a lot better than I do. And I'm sorry, Barcelona, if you see this, I don't mean to downplay you or downtalk you. I'm just trying to provide some commentary on what's going on, which is very difficult if it's so scrambly like that, of course. But here he got the simple auto combo into the unique attack from Anila and closes out the round with the, I forgot its name, with the guard crash attack. Going into the second round, I just did whatever and he got her jump attack, her jump special, and got way in. And now playing some footsies, I get in but I don't get any combo, any knockdown. Just trying to do something, and I get mauled here. I wanted to press a button with him after the auto combo and got deleted for that. And also I didn't use my alpha counter style attack to get the follow up of the guard crush away. And that was my first match, we will see more later on. After that humiliating defeat, I grinded some more casual matches before I decided to check out the online lobby, which is a return to the classic Arc System Works lobby format we know and love, but hypercharged. You got all the stickers and emotes you would want, but can also travel around the hub more freely than before. You can jump and even glide from higher elevation, and the jump pads really make use of that. I don't know if the islands are different depending on the lobby, or day, or anything, and if there's a treasure to find, but I think it's pretty cool they made the lobby more alive and added extra activities such as soccer. I am usually the type to ignore all of that though, and just queue up for rank, but I am sure some of you will really appreciate the extra care they put in here. I know that BlazBlue cross-tag battle lobbies were pretty popular. It is not perfect though, since there were no indicators for Wi-Fi and connection quality, the jump felt clunky, and I caught the hair physics randomly resetting itself. Another reason I prefer handcrafted animations over physics. I mean, look at Jamie's hair. Personally, I think the lobby avatars are charming, but pale in comparison to the perfection we saw in BlazBlue cross-tag battle. With all the exploring being done, let's get back to some Anila gaming and take a look at my last set of the beta and see how much I have improved. Here we are again with the last match, or rather the last set that I played. So this was after 49 matches against what I I'd say is a pretty good Ferry player, but of course I don't really know that much about the community or how strong each player is. This is still something more difficult. At the very least, he knows his game plan very well. And I got a few hits in here. I still struggle with the character as a whole, about especially with offense. So for most of the beta, I have played very defensively. But in this round, it's all neat, actually. Even offense, I get a few reads here and there, and completely steamrolled in the first round. But of course, that's not everything here. The second round, he appears to zone me out a lot better, so I can't run him over. So it's actually pretty difficult. What I experience in the match actually is that I have superior full screen zoning, but in everything mid range and higher range stuff, Ferry is obviously better than Anila. So I try to use that to my advantage and get in. When I'm mid range and back up, and I'm not quite in a range where I could attack. So the thing about Ferry is that she can obviously set up those creatures. Gigi, probably, I guess it's called, that can stun lock you quite a while. So I'm trying to stay out of those, as to not get pressured afterwards. Still, Ferry has a superior range, so I have to be careful getting in. In this round I lose, still, my opponent still had about 40% health left. In this round they apparently don't want me to full screen zone with sheep, so they run in. I don't think that's a smart choice to do with Ferry, but of course nothing is on the line, so you can just play the way you want to have fun. But you see that I'm using the auto combos a lot more. I get a few good hits in with the 2C, the anti-air button, which is actually pretty long range. Here I use the guard crush thingy to extend the combo. Go back to some full screen zoning. Here I get hit, but as they got hit it themselves, they couldn't follow up and pressure me. They only have a slither of health left, and they use their extended super, not super, their enhanced special to lock me down longer. I use my enhanced special back to lock them down, didn't help, but they rushed into my 2C, or they dive kicked into my 2C. So yeah, this match again, starting out a little bit more zony from their side. They got hit by the sheep for no reason, but we take those. Locking me down again with the special, with the creature, La Creatura, and yeah, all in all, it locks me down very well this round. And yeah, at this point I try to use a forward dodge, but I'm a bit clumsy with that, and I believe I could work a lot more once I change my controls again and get used to using that evasion. So it would be easier to get near Ferry then, and that would also improve my chances in this particular matchup. I'm staying patient, using my DP-like attack, so invincible reversal, that I guess most characters have with down special button, or of course a comment input, which I believe is different per character, but in her case it's the classical DP input, 6-3 in enemy notation. I actually get a few good hits in here. That was, yeah, I jumped into the corner voluntarily, of course not really good. That was an is an overhead actually. You always see that when there's exclamation points above characters' heads, and they get me again with the overhead, and they win the second match, but they won most of the matches three played, or rather all of them. We had a friendly smiley conversation afterwards before I had to quit the game, but before that I had to check out the infamous community guestbook. Personally, I'm quite fond of these kinds of in-game forums, so I'm glad the guestbook is here. All in all, I enjoyed my time with the Granblue Fantasy Versus beta. The online worked great, the game looks amazing, and I appreciate all the love they put into everything. And I mean everything. Look, you can pet the sheep. There are some issues I pointed out, though they hopefully fix by the time the full game launches. Like missing connection indicators. What's up with that? As a beautiful Blaze Blue Bro, it still takes some adjustment on my part to get truly comfortable with the game, so I'll try out the game a lot more once it's released, and maybe create some more videos about it to cover more FGC over here, and not only Blaze Blue. That's all, folks. Thank you so much for watching my video, hope you enjoyed it. If you did, leave a like, subscribe, and maybe tell me your opinion about Granblue Fantasy Versus Rising in the comments. All of these things help small channels like mine a lot, so thanks. Until then, bye bye!